morning and a very warm welcome. You are watching Janata Television and this is the English Bulletin with me, Anustha Acharya. The top stories first. Central Committee meeting of CPN Unified Socialist underway. Chairman Nepal urges ministers to work responsibly. CPN Unified chairperson against fake news in the name of press freedom. Sambhu Shrestha announced as chairman of Socialist Press Organization Nepal. Nepal's share market in a downward trend. Experts say the current trend is a result of liquidity crunch. Dozens of Maoist rebels killed in India gone battle. Three special commandos also wounded in the long hour clash. And Mbappe scores hat-trick as France hammers Kazakhstan, the world champion's second place in next year's World Cup. Now the news in detail. The second Central Committee meeting of CPN Unified Socialist has started in the capital. Chairman Madhav Kumar Nepal and senior leader Chalanath Khanal presented their written statements on the first day of the meeting held at Kathmandu Heritage Garden. Chairman Nepal urged the party rank and file to speed up the party's publicity campaign to expand the public relations of the party. He also appealed to the leaders and cadres, reach out to the general public, maintain wide participation of the youth, change the costly election system and end the sources of corruption. He urged the leaders to adopt a communist working style and to revive the system of self-criticism. Likewise, Chairman Nepal on behalf of the party has urged the participating ministers in the government to work responsibly. He has also proposed a plan to sell stickers with slogans of cultural change in every nook and corners to meet the expenses of Unified Socialist. CPN Unified Socialist Chairman Madhav Kumar Nepal has said that media houses cannot publish news as per their liking in the name of press freedom. Speaking at a program organized by Socialist Press Organization that is close to a party, Chairman Nepal said that no one is allowed to present a god as a demon and vice versa in the name of press freedom. The former Prime Minister also claimed that his party is headed in the path to ensure justice, equality and prosperity for the people. On the occasion, party's Deputy General Secretary and Publicity Department in charge Jagannath Khatliora stressed that the media sector should proactively write stories in favour of nationality and livelihood. Similarly, Socialist Press Organization Nepal's chairman Sambhu Shrestha informed that the organization would conduct nationwide activities in favor of working journalists. The program was organized to announce a 251-member committee of the Social Press Organization Nepal under the leadership of Shrestha. Among other office bearers of the organization are Prakash Khatiora, Senior Vice Chair, Sital Saha, Vice Chair, Bhavani Karke, Woman Vice Chair and Mudivir Wahing Rai, Inclusive Vice Chair. Finance Minister Janardhan Sharma has said that media persons should be able to establish truth as per the expectation of the people. Speaking at the inauguration of the newly elected working committee of Kaski chapter of Press Centre Nepal recently, he stressed on the need for a role of media to keep the people informed. It is the responsibility of the media personnel to alert the government of its shortcomings in course of establishing the struggle for Federal Democratic Republic and its achievements, said the minister. During the address, Minister Sharma added that the government was ready to extend any support to the journalists for the capacity development. Newly elected chairperson Krishna Davari expressed his commitment to work for quality development of journalism and journalists. The district convention has selected a 21-member district committee under the chairmanship of Davari. This is Janata Bulletin. We'll be right back after a short break. Welcome back after the break. We continue with other national news. The government yesterday confirmed 260 new cases of coronavirus across the country. Following the latest round of tests, the total cases of coronavirus in the country have climbed to 816,675, while the number of active cases has dropped to 7,278. The death toll from coronavirus has climbed to 11,471 after the virus claimed two more lives yesterday. Nepal is currently among top 46 countries that have been most affected by the pandemic. The USA tops the list with over 47.89 million confirmed cases, followed by India with over 34.42 million cases. Coronavirus has infected more than 253.66 million people across the world and claimed over 5.11 million lives. And now the news from economic front. The share market of Nepal is in a downward trend due to the liquidity crunch faced by banks and financial institutions, as well as the recently concluded festival of Diwali and Chhath. As per the latest data, the NSE index is in a bearish trend. In the past 1 week, share transactions took place during only 3 days. Experts believe that this is due to the strict measures adopted by BFIS in providing loans. Nepal Rashtra Bank has adopted a policy to allow loans for share transaction worth up to 120 million from one institution. Analysts believe this is to be one of the major reasons for the downward trend of the share market. Time for a short break here at Janata Bulletin. Stay tuned for international news. Welcome back now to the international news. At least 26 Maoist rebels have been killed in a gun battle with Indian government forces in a remote forest, according to media reports on the latest clash in the long-running armed conflict. Police said their three commandos were badly wounded in the hours-long clash on Sunday in the dense forest of Gadricholi district, some 1,000 kilometers, 620 miles east of Mumbai, the capital of Maharashtra state. They were airlifted to the city of Nagpur for treatment. Gadchiroli is one of the dozens of Maoist hotbeds dotting the mineral-rich districts of central and eastern India, where tens of thousands of fighters are battling government forces. Police said the gun battle erupted after special police commandos intercepted a group of rebels in the Mardintola forest. At least 26 Naxals are dead, and officials from Maharashtra police told AFP News Agency on condition of anonymity, using a local term for the left-wing rebels. The Maoists are known as Naxalites because the left-wing rebellion began in 1967 in the Naxalbari village of the eastern West Bengal state. The officer said special forces were still conducting a search operation in the area amid sporadic gunfire. You are watching Janata Bulletin, and now the latest from the world of sports. Kylian Mbappe scored his first hat-trick for France as the reigning world champions secured their place at next year's World Cup in Qatar in style by thrashing Kazakhstan. Mbappe got 4 of 8 goals, with the striker's first three coming in the opening 30 minutes. He completed the route with a late fourth. Karim Benzema got 2 after the break. Adrien Rabiot and Antoine Griezmann with a penalty were the other 6 scorers. Mbappe's hat-trick was the first by France players in the competition international since Dominique Rochetau in 1985. His first came in the 6th minute when he turned in an early cut back before he finished a Kingsley Coman cross from close range and handed in a 3rd. Victory guarantees France will top Group D as they have 15 points, 4 clear of 2nd place Finland with 1 game remaining. We are at the end of Janata Bulletin and the headlines once again. Central Committee meeting of CPN Unified Socialist underway. Chairman Nepal urges ministers to work responsibly. CPN Unified chairperson against fake news in the name of press freedom. Sambhu Shrestha announced as chairman of Socialist Press Organization Nepal. Nepal's share market in a downward trend. Experts say the current trend is a result of liquidity crunch. Dozens of Maoist rebels killed in India gun battle, 3 special commandos also wounded in the hours-long clash. And Mbappe scores hat-trick as France hammers Kazakhstan's. The world champions secure place in next Here's World Cup. And that's all from the English News Desk for today. You can follow Janata Television and our programs on various social media platforms, including on our website, janatasamacha.com. Keep watching Janata Television. Namaste.